This year, iOS 18 is bringing 5 awesome new features to Safari. Let's jump right in. The biggest change is a new page menu that you can find by tapping this button on the left of the address bar. It's much more simple and visually laid out. On the top, you have options for hide distracting items if a pop-up is preventing you from seeing the content of the page. More on that later. Below, you have options for turn off content blockers and reduce privacy protections that'll reload the page with those features disabled in case they're interfering with how the page is supposed to work. And if you have any Safari extensions installed, you'll see those in the middle. Along the bottom from left to right, Find on Page will let you search for text specifically on the page. Text size will make the entire content of the page bigger or smaller. And the More button is an additional junk drawer of features. You can request the desktop version of the site, print it, customize website-specific settings for permissions, add it to your favorites or bookmarks or reading list. A lot of these features are also in the share sheet as well, but here in the page menu, you can customize the order and add your favorites for quicker access. Number 2, the modern web is sadly full of irritating banners and pop-ups, begging you to subscribe to newsletters, autoplaying videos you don't want to watch. If you install an ad blocker to restore some degree of sanity, like my personal favorites, Vinegar and AdGuard, suddenly you start getting pop-ups begging you to turn off your ad blocker. Well, the new Hide Distracting Items feature is here to the rescue. Find it in the page menu. All you have to do is tap on the thing you don't like and tap hide, and it'll fade away into dust like Thanos himself has snapped away half of the modern web, but only the irritating half. Tap the Done button and you can read your web page in distraction-free bliss. Number 3. Occasionally, the page menu will have a sparkle icon on it. Despite what you might think, that doesn't indicate that the page menu is lemony fresh and clean. It instead tells you that information highlights are available for the page you're on. If you're on a website for a restaurant or business or a hotel, you'll have a widget on the top that shows you their operating hours, their cost, and you can tap on it to get instant directions in Apple Maps. If you're on a page that talks about a famous historical figure, you'll see a quick biography, and you can tap to open it in Wikipedia. Or if you're reading an article about a new musical artist or album or song, you'll have an embedded widget that you can open in Apple Music and listen right away. Number 4. If you're reading an article, you can tap and hold on the page menu to jump directly into reader mode, where you'll discover 2 great new features. If it's a big long article and you don't have time to read the whole thing, you can tap on the summary. It'll summarize the main points or the thesis of the article for you. This particular summary feature isn't powered by Apple Intelligence, so you can get it on all devices running iOS 18. Second, if the article is properly formatted with subheadings and sections, you'll find an automatically generated table of contents. Tap to expand the list, and tap to jump directly to the section you want to read. Both of these features are great time savers. Finally, number 5, another great feature of iOS 18 is the ability to lock any app behind Face ID, or on an older device, Touch ID. In the case of Safari, if someone steals your phone, this can prevent them from getting into your browser tabs or your browser history. It's really easy. Just tap and hold on any icon on your home screen and tap Require Face ID. You'll get a pop-up explaining how it works. It'll scan your face. And if that's successful, the app will be locked. Anytime you tap on the icon on your home screen or switch to it from the app switcher, it'll first have to scan your face. And if that's unsuccessful, you can still enter in your passcode as well. If you ever want to turn this off, it's just as easy. From the home screen, tap and hold on the icon and tap Don't Require Face ID. It'll do one last scan, and then it'll be free. If you want to learn more about this feature, including the ability to hide an app from your phone, I wrote a full article about it that you can find here. Remember to like and subscribe so you see more great iOS 18 features and tips. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.